So you're trying to get pregnant and you've been to see your doctor to get some basic fertility testing done. And your doctor has ordered something called a day 21 progesterone test or serum progesterone. This day 21 test is one of the easiest ways to find out if you're ovulating or not. But as you might have heard, the test is not foolproof. And if it's not done correctly, you could be told you're not ovulating, even when you are. Not something you want to hear when you're trying to get pregnant. So in this video, I'm going to explain how to do your day 21 progesterone test the right way to make sure you get a reliable result and to find out for sure if you're ovulating or not. Hi, I'm Juliet Miller. I'm a trained natural fertility specialist with over 20 years experience, and welcome to Focus on Fertility, the YouTube channel dedicated to supporting you on your fertility journey with science-based tips and information you can trust to help you get pregnant as soon as possible. Okay, before I dive in and explain how to do your progesterone test the right way, I just want to answer the question as to why you'd have this test done in the first place. The day 21 progesterone test, or serum progesterone, is one of the first fertility tests that your doctor's likely to order for you if you're having difficulty getting pregnant. And sometimes it's also ordered in advance of trying to conceive as part of a preconception checkup. Normally, your doctor will also test some of your other hormone levels at the same time, such as follicle-stimulating hormone, estradiol, and perhaps anti-malarian and thyroid hormones also. The day 21 progesterone test is used specifically to find out if you're ovulating or not, and perhaps to also check if your progesterone levels are high enough for implantation. And I explain a bit more about this test and what the test results actually mean in another video, which I'll link to up here and in the description below. Now, I am a fan of the progesterone test. It can be very useful, but the test comes with a huge caveat, and that is that you'll only get a reliable result if your blood is drawn on the right day of your menstrual cycle. If it's not done on the right day, you can get a result that's inconclusive, or even worse, as I mentioned before, a result that suggests you're not ovulating even when you are. Now, you might be thinking that surely it's obvious what day of your cycle you should get the test done. Day 21, right? After all, the test is often called the day 21 blood test. But what if I told you that there's a very good chance this will not actually be the correct day for you, and that doing the test on day 21 of your cycle could actually give you an unreliable result and potentially cause you a whole lot of unnecessary worry? Let me explain why this might be. If you've watched my other video on this that I mentioned before, you'll know that before ovulation, your progesterone levels are low. And then after ovulation, the levels increase dramatically. And your progesterone levels reach their peak around 7 days after ovulation. It's this peak in progesterone that we want to measure. The problem is most women don't know exactly when they've ovulated. So they don't know when 7 days after ovulation is. And if you've watched some of my other videos, you'll know that most fertility apps and even sometimes ovulation predictor kits aren't actually a reliable indicator of the day you've ovulated. So because of this, the progesterone blood test is often ordered for day 21 of your cycle, on the assumption that you've ovulated around day 14. Day 14 ovulation plus 7 days to reach peak progesterone equals day 21. But this is a big assumption because, as a number of scientific studies have proven, and as I see with my clients all the time, most women do not ovulate on the textbook day 14. So getting the test done on day 21 of your cycle may not be the right day for you. The right day for you will depend entirely on when you ovulate in that particular cycle. So let's take a look at a couple of examples to show you what I mean. If you ovulate early, for example, on day 10 of your cycle, you want to be doing the test around day 17, 7 days after ovulation. If you wait until day 21, that's going to be too late. By day 21, your progesterone levels will be on their way back down or quite low again, and you'll have missed the peak that we want to measure. At the other end of the scale, if you ovulate late on day 23, for example, you'd want to do the progesterone test around day 30, again, 7 days after ovulation. A day 21 test would be much too early in this case. On day 21, you wouldn't have even ovulated yet, so your progesterone levels would still be low. In both these cases, as I mentioned before, these lower progesterone levels could make the test inconclusive, or even suggest that you're not ovulating, even when you are. So, what should you do to make sure you do get a reliable result? If you've got regular cycles, one thing you can do is to work out when your next period is due and subtract 7 days from that due date. And your doctor might have suggested this to you already. This will often give you the correct timing, but not always, especially if you have irregular cycles. An even better thing to do, and you probably know what I'm going to say here, is to chart your fertility. That is to chart your basal body temperature and your cervical fluid, because this is an easy, reliable method you can use at home to figure out exactly when you're ovulating. And in my Fast Track to Pregnancy program, I show you step by step exactly how to do this. But ironically, if you chart your fertility, you won't actually need to do a progesterone test because your fertility charts will already tell you whether you're ovulating or not. But it can still be helpful to have the blood test as a backup. Now, once you get your progesterone result back, and you might have received yours back already, your doctor will be able to explain to you what it means. But if this hasn't happened, or you still need further clarification, again, check out my other video on this to find out what your progesterone level means for ovulation and for your chances of getting pregnant. And I'll link to that video in the description below. So, to summarize, the day 21 progesterone blood test can be a useful and easy test to find out if you're ovulating or not. But to get a reliable result, your blood must be drawn around 7 days after ovulation, and often this is not on day 21 of your cycle. And of course, the best way, in my opinion, to figure out the day that you're ovulating and to give you lots of other great information about your fertility is to chart your fertility. So that's it for today. If you found this video useful, please give it a big thumbs up, give it a like, and let me know in the comments what you found of most value or if you have any questions. And of course, if you'd like to see more videos like this one, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified when I upload new content. I hope that helps. Thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in another video soon. Bye for now.